Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ESL 1 Cologne and welcome to the grand final. Okay. We've got our Kappa signs, we've got our white signs, we've got our NIP signs, we've got our fanatic signs. I just need to make sure that you guys have some throat left. So, can I hear you for Counter-Strike Global Offensive? Yeah, okay. All right. That's good. You're going to need those lungs, trust me, because this is going to be a cracking final. Today I learned that actually Swedes are like Koreans in StarCraft. You just can't keep them down. They win absolutely everything. It is an all-Swedish final. It's Fnatic versus NIP. And before we get the teams out and we start this grand final, it's time to check in with a couple of players who've had some magical moments. First of all, let's check in with Olaf Meister.
The bomb defuse has to happen. Flusher gets it. In they go. Fnatic are going into the final. Can you believe it? What play from Fnatic?
I think everyone is just totally focused on the grand prize. It's amazing. You want to play these finals. It's amazing. Our team is really strong because we have five players that can make huge plays every round. So we are always there trusting in our team that we can always win the round, no matter what situation we are in. It was a really big challenge to get to the grand final because every good team was here, and it's awesome to be in the final. The reason Fnatic will win this tournament is because we have five really good players, and we can beat any team, anytime, anywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Fnatic! And as a Ninjas in Pyjamas fan, there's only one man you need when you need to get things done. When you need to get them right, it's get right.
This is Freiburg, disciplined to the end, waiting for something to hit, and it'll be existing. Get right at Freiburg, and they're only one frag away from the final. It's Kaylee versus NIP. Can he deliver? No! Ninjas in Pyjamas charge into the grand final of the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Challenge here at the ESL 1 in Cologne. Phenomenal play from NIP. Coming back from one map down, they have rallied and they have launched themselves into the grand final.
How intense is this tournament? It's unbelievable. I've never played like so many close games in my like whole career, and I've been playing for like 15 years. And somehow it's always been ending up in cobblestone for us, and we're always making it somehow in the end, and I'm just super happy. The crowd here is in Cologne on the Köln Messe is just amazing to just see like a beautiful Counter-Strike is played and the top teams playing each other, and they're cheering on for you, and if it feels like they're cheering more for us, but it doesn't matter in the end because everyone is here for playing and everyone should be cheered on. We should win this tournament mostly because we have brought so many exciting games in this tournament and the people are cheering on for us. We have a massive support from the whole world, and we just want to redeem, like, give them the payback and just give them the win, especially for the NIP fans that have been cheering us for us since 3 years. They're so amazing and they never stop supporting us. We just want to bring the gold to them and show them what they have been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ninjas in Pyjamas. So here we go. Hold on to your seats at home. Hold on to your seats in the crowd. It's almost time for the grand final. It's Ninjas in Pyjamas versus Fnatic. And we have our analysis team back once more, led by Sir Scoots.
Thank you very much, Red Eye. You know, I got to start off with, you know, story time with Scoots, right? I'm the old man of esports. The first version of this game dropped in 1999, right? And we were the esport for many years. We set legendary matchups. We set the business side of esports on fire. Like, we helped grow what everyone else is enjoying now, right? And then our game kind of went away. And literally, I don't think any of us thought in our wildest dreams 4 years ago, 5 years ago, that really we would be doing this again. not for the first time like DreamHack, not for the second time like in Poland, but we're at our third major. On top of all that, we have two historic brands in the building, NIP versus Fnatic. And much like sports rivalries, Fnatic beat them in the very first one. NIP's been second place in every one. Is this the one they take home?
Well, I don't. Before I even attempt to answer that question, and I'm like you, man, I'm so pumped.
I'm so hyped, dude.
I've had a D tie.
The hype is real.
The tie is off.
The hype is real.
I'll learn a tie one for next event. But honestly, like you say, I'll tell you 10 people I didn't ever think there would be anything this big going on, and that's the guys on stage, because they've played away for years. They're made up of veterans, and this is just absolutely huge. Record numbers of people watching, a record crowd. I've never seen anything like the atmosphere in there. And like you say, two historic brands that have been in the game for so long, and this is it. This is the big time. So it's just absolutely amazing, and it's going to be too close to call. It's just going to, who's marshal their emotions better in this like tense situation?
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, like you guys said, these exact teams met in the first major in the finals. Fnatic ended up taking that one home. NIP is obviously really thirsty for blood when it comes back to, when it comes to that Swede revenge. So a lot is on the line, not only just national pride because they're both Swedish teams, but also just to win your first major for NIP. So, I mean.
Absolutely. Look, yeah. I mean, I don't think revenge is the right word in a way, because this is almost like, right, are NIP going to realize their destiny? This is what we're talking about. They've been the number one team. Everybody knows that. Their trophy cabinet is absolutely stacked.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have a major in it. And that is a travesty in a lot of ways.
Exactly.
Everybody thought when the first major came along, it was going to be theirs.
Yeah.
It didn't happen for them. And even NIP were confused. I mean, they went away and they were like, how have we not won a major? How have we just kind of been second best when we know we're the best?
Yeah.
And Fnatic were the people that upset that. And they never lived up to that hype after that. Yeah. So Fnatic need to show they weren't just a flash in the pan, and NIP need to show that they truly are the greatest. There's so much going on here.
Yeah, it's really crazy, because when that first matchup happened at DreamHack Winter between NIP and Fnatic, NIP were the heavy favorites. Not a single person I talked to at the whole venue had Fnatic winning that championship that day. So it was really upsetting to not only NIP, but everyone else.
I think, is this a veto?
Not quite yet.
Okay.
So let me do a little role reversal. You're on that stage, Sean. You're replacing either of those, any of those 10 guys. How do you, like, two sides of it. Fnatic has been able to sit, kind of rest up after their first match today, watch what just happened. So if you were them, how are you kind of recycling yourself back up? And if you're a NIP guy, how are you like bringing yourself back down?
Well, I think if you're a Fnatic, you're really trying to absorb everything you just saw. You're trying to really remember everything you saw NIP do, the positions they play. You're trying to remember kind of their preferences on certain maps and things like that. If you're NIP, on the other hand, you want to keep that momentum. You want to keep playing with aggression. You don't want to let up and really kind of turtle in a shell. So I really think NIP is kind of in a favorite position here heading into the final, because CSGO does favor teams that play with confidence, and NIP definitely is going to be rolling with confidence here.
I mean, I want to say as well, confidence, but nervous energy, right?
Yeah.
Nervous energy, because you know yourself as a competitor, and I've competed in sports. That adrenaline's pumping through your system right now. This is it. This is the moment that all your preparation, all of the tournament has been about, right here and right now. And in a way, it's a great leveler, because it's going to be about who can marshal those feelings internally, who's going to keep their head in the clutch moments. And NIP have more experience technically, but that's not going to matter, because I think their head maybe is going to be like, well, this is it for us. You know, this is, again, that destiny moment. It kind of levels out both teams, makes it even playing field.
And you can tell how bad NIP wants it, because I've never seen Get Right be so excited on a match that didn't win a tournament than he was just now when they beat LDLC. He got out of his chair, jumped on PETA. He was thrilled. And to see Get Right like that, you just know he wants this really, really bad.
Yeah,
and you know, we have a saying, you know, always a bridesmaid, never a bride, right? And that's legendarily what they've been in these majors.
Yeah.
And again, they have been in a slump. There's no doubt about it. There's a question of, are they really the number one team right now based on the last couple months of, you know, of play, Gfinity, et cetera. So, like, I think Fnatic's like probably has way less pressure. A, they already got a major under their belt, and B, you know, they've actually had a better tournament. They've dropped one map to Na'Vi. That's it. So again, it's a battle of the Swedes, you know, the proverbial home of amazing Counter-Strike is Sweden, right? You cannot deny that.
While we're talking about emotions, let's bring pride to the table. Pronax is, you know, it got a real potential here to make history, you know, and I know you want to tell us why.
Yeah, so going into this final, I realized that Pronax has now taken two pretty much brand new squads that he formed to the finals of a major. The first one he won, and here's the second one. He legitimately has a chance to become the greatest leader in CSGO right now. And a lot of people want to put that on Existence or even like Fetish or even Exist. But if Pronax wins this major, it's going to be really hard to argue against him being the greatest leader in CSGO right now.
And, you know, whether you think players think about these things or not, I know they do. I mean, you are conscious about that. Everyone wants bragging rights. Everyone wants to be able to say, well, you know, look at my gaming CV. Look what I've achieved. You know, that the word achievements is rife through gaming and especially esports. You wear it on your sleeve. And I think Pronax has been one of those guys who, like you say, maybe he doesn't get the plaudits. I mean, people still talk about Existence as a top captain, even though that his teams are underperforming. Pronax absolutely deserves respect, and you go out and you earn it by coming up big in events like this.
And I think Pronax goes a lot under the radar in the CSGO community because his strats aren't as flashy. They don't involve smokes, molotovs, flashes. It's a lot of teamwork, and it really takes an eye to understand what he's doing with the teams when he forms and how he's getting these teams to the finals. And it's really it's a work of art, like what he's doing with these teams.
I mean, it's hard for captains in this situation as well, because we're talking about all the emotions that are going through your head. We're talking about that pride factor. We're talking about that nervousness, that fear factor. And then on top of that, you've got to be the level head. You've got to call for the rest of the team. You've got to see the big picture. Can you kind of explain how, you know, guys like yourself do that in these situations?
Yeah, so I mean, the main thing is that you have to research beforehand. You have to understand what the other team is going to do, and you have to be confident about your decisions. If you ever hesitate when you make a call, one of your teammates may doubt you and may not completely follow through with what you tell them to do, and then the whole strat's offline. So I think Pronax is a really confident leader, and his teammates all trust him. And you can tell after their first major, they all said Pronax OP and things like that. They loved him. He's a fantastic leader. His teammates love him. So he's not like one of those dictator leaders, and he's a team player.
Yeah, and it's something to think about, you know. Yeah. Devil Walk was one of those guys on stage. Yeah. If you remember the infamous bet to drop his pants, and he dropped his pants at DreamHack. Shout out to Devil Walk for your pants. Maybe we can get Devil Walk to drop his pants again or something. But now, again, we've talked about this a lot. This six-man guy that is not that cheerleader is actually assisting with, you know, informational stuff. They both have that in, obviously, Devil Walk and PETA, you know, which is new. So, again, what a feather in his cap for PETA if he actually pulls this all the way through.
Yeah.
I don't know if you agree. I think one of the things Devil Walk's going to really have to do here is focus on the guys from LGB that have just come into the team and maybe haven't played in a, you know, major football. They haven't played in a major final before.
I am worried about those two. They've played out of this world throughout this whole tournament. So there's really no reason for me to be worried about them. However, they haven't played at this level yet. And who knows, when they hold tab and they see that 300,000, 400,000 viewers mid-match, is that going to strike nerve in them? Hopefully not.
Yeah, but I think that's what Devil Walk's going to be doing. Yeah. I literally see, I mean, if I was a coach and I was doing his job, I'd be focusing on the guys that haven't been here before. What experience can I give to them? How can I keep them calm? Because they play brilliantly throughout the tournament, but again, your emotions can get you better of you in situations like this where it's just hugely important, and, you know, money's on the line, all that pressure.
And I know from talking with Devil Walk that he is that kind of person that can calm someone down. He's really good with people and can really talk someone through something. PETA, on the other hand, I've seen him be really tactical. I've seen him back here watching demos of other teams, really studying, getting NiP the strategic kind of backing that they need. So he's on a different level, because NiP don't really need to be calmed down. They have this experience. So it's a different kind of coach. So it's interesting to see the clash of the coaches like that too.
Yeah. And I think one of the cool things, you know, we're obviously this pregame, we're talking a lot about the emotions, because we've talked about maps. We've talked about their aim skills all weekend long, right? Obviously, 10 of the best guys on the planet about to play right now. One of the cool things that we've talked about a lot off camera is this new rule set where you're allowed one official timeout, again, much like sports. Not a technical one, not a problem with your mouse or keyboard. And again, back in the day, like players would fake kind of that stuff to get the timeout they needed to either regroup. But now you might even see it like they're using a timeout to ice the other team, right? Yeah. They might be in the lead and they pull that. But we've seen Nip call some crucial timeouts that then won them some rounds afterwards. You know, you kind of get off that losing streak.
It's such a great thing to bring to the game, purely and simply because, again, when your emotions are running away with you and this is such a momentum-based game, it's so easy to lose one round, two round, three round, four round, five round, and before you know it, you're like, this is out of control. This is a runaway train. How do we put the brakes on? And we've never had that facility before, really. I mean, a few tournaments here and there have offered timeouts. I'm so glad that we've now got these at the highest level as standard.
I'm thrilled, yeah. And even looking at the NIP-LDLC match from earlier, NIP, I believe, called the timeout when they were down 0-7.
Yeah.
And even though they didn't win that map, they got a lot of rounds late in that map, which I think propelled some momentum going into the second and third map.
Yeah.
So that it really helped them going forward, in my opinion.
So we have the NIP lineup here. Let's put quick walk through us.
Yeah, you do this because you played against these guys.
So obviously we have the in-game leader, Richard Exist Landstrom. Everyone's fan favorite, Patrick Forrest Lindberg. He's everyone's probably favorite fragger. Probably the greatest CS 1.6 player of all time. And then we have Christopher Getright Aslan, probably the best fragger in the world, the lurker, clutcher, really does everything for NIP. If he's having an off game, they may have a hard time winning this one, I'm not going to lie. Adam Freiberg, he's their entry fragger, really mad fragger, sprayer, kind of flashy player. And then we have Fifflerin as their opper and kind of the glue to the team.
All right, I think we got the map veto ready, so we're looking for the zoom in on that. And then we'll jump back in and get the other roster in just a second.
Again, as well, I want to ask you about this. So when the veto comes in, is there any chance that your emotions might get the better of you? Can you make mistakes in vetoes? Can you overlook a potential map that maybe you didn't want?
There can be some severe mistakes made in vetoes. NIP made a massive mistake in the last major by not vetoing Mirage and letting Virtus Pro end up playing that. This major, I don't see that happening again. NIP is going to veto Mirage, and I think Fnatic's going to veto NIP's best map, Nuke. So I think both teams are going to veto the other team's best map, and I hope that that's what we see, so that way we see some kind of even Counter-Strike on the other maps.
Yeah. We're still getting the veto organized, so actually, let's pull up that other team sheet right now, and then we'll get that out of the way.
So there you go. And again, you tell us all about Fnatic, Sean, because you know these teams inside out.
So we have Pronax, the leader of the team, which is who we were talking about earlier, really the mastermind behind everything. You'll often see him taking some kind of risky peeks and kind of doing the flash peeks and helping his teammates out. Really the team player, support player on the team, and he'll do a lot of stuff to get information to make calls later on in the round. We have Flusha. He's one of their kind of key fraggers. In my opinion, he's more of a lurk fragger. But he will come up big and win clutches a lot in rounds. So he actually propelled them through versus Na'Vi by winning a 1-on-3 to win it. JW, probably the most known player on Fnatic. He will literally do anything. He'll mag, he'll buy an AWP, he'll CZ, he'll rifle, he'll buy a shotgun. He will buy any gun and he will get a 3K with it. Krims, one of their newest additions, solo site player, excellent player, team player. You'll never see him making kind of individual plays and things like that, because he's always doing stuff for the better of the team. Excellent player. Olafmeister, he's their other new player that joined the team from LGB. Probably one of the best up-and-coming players in all of Europe. Excellent AWP, excellent rifles. In my opinion, the standout player to watch of this upcoming finals.
All right, let's get a zoom in on that map veto. Let's get this thing a-rolling.
See, I'm so psyched.
Rolling.
There we go.
There we go. All right, let's see what we got here. So Fnatic's got that first pick.
Yep, and it looks like they beat a Nuke. And Snipe vetoed Mirage.
Yeah, you called that one, brother.
Yeah. So now we have both Overpass and Cobblestone still remaining. Ooh, it looks like Fnatic picked Cobblestone.
Wow.
Oh, I wonder if that's just because they just saw NIP play Cobblestone maybe two times in a row.
Yeah, maybe.
So maybe
I'm really surprised by that pick.
Yeah, especially over Overpass, because we know Fnatic has an excellent Overpass. It's what got them here versus Dignitas.
T-side Cobblestone coming up.
Wow, that's...
In the final of a major.
That's... And cash. Wow, we haven't seen much cash lately.
No, we haven't. And I know NIP, they do fancy themselves on cash.
Oh,
but,
yeah, they're very good.
You know, but I've seen them lose to some, you know, not great teams on it as well. It's That's an interesting pick. So I didn't quite catch the last one.
Last map, Decider, the map of Counter-Strike GO. Inferno.
Really?
And that'll have Fnatic starting as the CT side, although
okay, well,
not so important on that map.
What are your thoughts on the maps? I mean, I know we've talked mostly about emotions, but that veto, who do you think it favors?
I think it favors NIP. They've been playing Cobblestone this whole tournament. They're really warmed up on it. They've probably seen every scenario that can be thrown at them because they played it 4 times now, I think. They played it tons. So I would have much rather see Fnatic choose Overpass, but apparently they have some maybe counters planned for NIP's Cobblestone. Going into Cash, which was Nip's choice, I think Nip are heavy favorites on Cash.
Yep.
That's not really a map that I often see Fnatic play. They have yet to play at this tournament, I believe. Right. And yeah, I don't even think I've ever seen Fnatic play Cash. So.
Yeah, I think they had one game at Gfinity against London Conspiracy, which they won 16-6. Okay. But London Conspiracy hadn't played it at all. Yeah. So besides that, you're right. It's not a map they're going to be overly familiar on. Yeah. And I'm just wondering, again, getting back to the sort of emotions and things, do you think maybe Pronax has kind of overthought it there by picking Cobblestone first? Do you think he's maybe trying to, mind game Nip at all?
He could be, because something that is in your head after you play a best of three like NIP just did, where the other team, you know the other team just watched you play a map. You know they know all your tactics. So it could psych you out. It could make you do things that are just absolutely ridiculous and just literally dig your own grave.
And what do you make of this, right? So we've just seen Fnatic. They're up. They're doing the three musketeers, hands all piled on. Let's do it. Obviously, 5 musketeers. I can't count, really.
Leg?
And then you look over at Nip.
So casual.
Look at that, though.
Look at that leg.
Serious. I mean, what do you think? What does that say about the two teams?
I think Nipper are ready. They're ready. You see Forrest has the hand warmer out below his monitor, warming up his hands, making sure everything's feeling good. So NIP are ready.
Okay.
All right. Well, there you have it, guys.
Predictions.
We're about to start this. Oh, yeah. Okay. I didn't want to throw you, get you set up for this, but let's have some quick predictions. Really quick.
NIP 2-1.
Okay.
I'm just going to agree with the pro. It's been such a crazy tournament.
All right. There you have it. Folks, this is the start for the $100,000. Second place takes a nice $50,000 home, but it's not even about the money at this point. It's about the pride, all those good things. That being said, first map. Take it away, on fire, Anders and Semler.
Ow, ow. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is it, the grand finals. We finally made it, and it's going to be a rematch of the first major final.
Yes, it is. This is revenge time for NIP, or it's Fnatic's turn to take it once again with a slightly different lineup, but this could not, I don't think it could be any better than this, and the atmosphere here at Gamescom is completely off the hook at this point.
It's perfect, man. It really is perfect. The crowd is hyped. There's a line all the way around the viewing area because these seats are up. People can't see. They have to wait to get in. It's crowded. Everybody wants to see this final. This is the final we were hoping for in the end because a rematch is a thing of beauty. Fnatic, as it was expressed on the analyst desk, they have so much to prove here. If they can take 2 major championship titles, that's a strong claim to best team in the world right now.
Yeah, and I think Sean put it very well. I think one of the guys to watch for on that Fnatic lineup is Olaf Meister, one of the top up-and-coming players in the whole of Europe, which almost means the whole of the world. I think Cloud9 showed us, at least this tournament, that there's something to be said for North American Counter-Strike 2. But going into this, I think Olaf Meister is going to be the man to watch on Fnatic.
Yes, absolutely. Him and Krims both have come through so many times for that team. Olaf Meister, definitely the point man there for Fnatic, but now we're looking at the brain behind Nip, Exist, who has been doing tremendous work, as well as Freiburg for Nip. But it looks like we are not wasting any time. We are going to get right into it. The pistol round about to begin here on Cobble. And this is all pressure on Nip to get a strong start here, because you can be sure that Pronax, that last match versus LDLC, he was sitting there with his notebook and he was scribbling away furiously. He knows exactly what Nip are going to be up to here.
Yeah, I still consider this a really big risk, but Pronax, I mean, he's definitely proven he knows what he's doing this tournament. Otherwise, they wouldn't have made it so far. Fnatic versus NIP. And we are live. So welcome to ESL 1 2014 here in Cologne. Now let's see, Fnatic, they are starting on the more favored side, and NIP going with a lot of aggression and already losing a fair bit of health of Freiburg and Forest. So that's a problem, but they might catch Flusher here. Pronex already going down. Flusher got to get back to safety, but there is no safety. Freiburg almost takes him down after dropping his teammate. Fuflaren goes down. Crims, the backup is here. Flusher stays alive and takes down Forest. That's a knife on JW, but it's not enough.
Crims gets it. Crims in the first round. Yeah, the first map has knifed Exist.
Yeah, and Exist knife his teammate. There's a double knife in the pistol. I think that officially initiates the grand final.
That is a statement. JW wanted to make a point there. We do not respect you, Nip. This title is ours. We will claim our second major championship title. There's not a whole lot you can do about it because I'm going to actually shank you to get it. That's amazing. Fnatic with a fantastic start already in this map. And that is really, I mean, Nip, that has got to be a big blow dealt to their confidence here. I mean, that crossfire set up by Fnatic to hold off that B site, Flush is staying alive so long, and then to cap it with a knife. That is not how things were supposed to go here for Nip.
I think NIP are going to be pretty confident when it comes to losing rounds here. They have had nothing. Their whole run to this grand final has been nothing but close games. Mm-hmm. So at this point, if nothing else, they've proven to themselves and to everyone watching, they are capable of making these comebacks happen. So hopefully they won't lose their composure in the middle of the match here. Fnatic, on the other hand, they really have been looking dangerously strong this tournament.
Absolutely. I mean, they took out Dignitas in the semis, and that Dignitas is a team that we were all saying you have to keep your eye on them, just like VP. VP getting taken out in the quarterfinals, but Dignitas into the semis, and you're thinking, okay, Fnatic versus Dignitas, there's no way to call it. This could go anyway, but Fnatic did it in style 2-0. So this is, I mean, they have all the confidence going into this final match here versus their old nemesis, Ninjas in Pajamas. All of the pressure is on them. And so far, this second round, it doesn't look like NIP are going to be able to do to Fnatic what they did to LDLC in the last best of three.
Now, they did purchase an AK, which makes a lot of sense because you do get 1,500 for that knife, so no issue at all. You know, trying to pick up an AK and do something about it. Not really, I think, even a big investment for NIP. They didn't get the bomb down, so they might as well. Normally, they would have just gone for C-sets and armor, mm-hmm. but because they had the knife, they could go for an AK instead, and that's kind of a cool switch up.
But that's the benefit of that, because just to make it perfectly clear, you get $1,500 if you get a knife kill. That's why it's so valuable to go for it at times when you have the chance. And so, I totally agree with you. I mean, NIP going for it, why not, right? If they can catch Fnatic off guard, they've got SMGs. I mean, Pronex has actually got a Bison right now. If you can take advantage of that, that would be huge. But now we have to see here, NIP not wasting any time at all, rushing straight out onto the B site. Crims holding solid with the help of Olafmeister.
Yeah, and very nice hold here from the counter-terrorist side. They don't lose a single person. Crims gonna pick up a triple kill. And that is one of the things that NIP did have some success with last time they played this map was that rush out towards the B bomb site. Mm-hmm. So maybe Fnatic have figured that much out, but there are a lot of different options and NIP haven't tested out nearly any of them yet. Now they have rifles picked up, no AWP on either side, and JW still with a Mag 7, which is another point that that Sean was picking up during the pregame analysis here, is that JW can use just about any weapon.
He can, and he's famous for it, but we've seen what he can do, especially, I mean, Fnatic on Nuke, right? That was the first time, or the big time, we saw that Swag 7 really being put to use for JW. He funded his team throughout the entire half. He's done it in the past as well in Overpass, so JW is to be feared when he has that shotty in hand, and he's already got $6,000 in the bank as well, so going into the next round here, Fnatic have plenty of options. They have all of the money. It's all on NIP now to get some big kills and actually take this fourth round by. And there you go. Get right. Finding Crims just through the smoke there as well. Very finely done.
Yeah, tossing a Molotov down into the drop zone and then casually turns and takes down a player right through the smoke. It's a really annoying start for Fnatic. Well, JW down here in the middle. And this is a pretty cool position to play if you're going to have a Mag 7, yeah. Then why would you not play when they have to get up close to you? All of this is Mag 7 range at this point, so it's not at all a bad idea. But NIP looks like they are adjusting a little bit, leaving one guy over towards A and moving everybody else over towards the B. Bombsite, they're gonna be jumping through the smoke here and not connecting. It's all of Meister. He goes down. Now it's a 3-on-5. Flusher trying to bring it back. Will drop get right. Can they get into the bombsite? Pronex is still holding strong here, and there is not a lot of health on Exist right now. 20 seconds, there's the grenade. Boom, Exist is gone. Fuflower next. Freiburg and Forrest are left. It's a 2-on-2 here. They must realize Pronex goes down. Freiburg again. Absolute clutch. Master and Forrest from behind will drop JW, and the fourth round is a success for NIP. Semler, tell me, How long is Freiburg going to keep this up?
I certainly hope for Nip's sake that it's going to be this entire best of three, because he, throughout this entire tournament, has been doing amazing work for this team, just getting entry frags, locking down those clutch rounds. Freiburg is a huge reason why they're here in this final right now, and I'm not surprised to see that it's him that makes it possible, because for a second there, it was looking very nasty. Pronex sitting on that bomb, on that B site. If Freiburg misses that shot, it's done, it's over for Nip, and we're looking at Fnatic with four rounds on the board. So this is exactly how Nip have to bounce back in this. This is going to give them the confidence going forward now. But we already see, I mean, Fnatic had so much money to invest into this round.
And speaking of confidence, JW just decided, instead of hiding behind the smoke that was thrown towards him, he actually pushed through to try and take a shot before he fell back. So that's really a sign that he is feeling on his A game here. But he has missed both the two options he had so far, and just going to be waiting down in the middle here.
JW with that AWP, exactly what we expect to see here. Olfmeister has it as well, and this is something that we have to mention here for Fnatic. Both of those players are some of the best offers in the world. Olfmeister is terrifying with the weapon, but of course everybody knows JW and what he's capable of. But right now, he's not exactly connecting with his shots, and he will have to fall back. Forrest will get the punish on Flusha, and that's actually the defense somewhat weakened here on the A site. They lose a man, and Fnatic have to start wondering exactly where Nip are going to be coming from.
What's the adjustment? This is such a big map, so getting pickoffs is really great, but if you don't do it too early, you're not gonna have that much time to get into a bomb site. So look at the clock here. 30 seconds, Olofmeister still holding over by A, and he's not gonna miss. Takes down Fiflower and goes for a second peek. That one isn't gonna connect, but he's still back here. They're getting close now. Olofmeister with a second. Are we gonna see a third? He's looking for the triple. He's not gonna get it. Get right. We'll take him down, but look at the clock now. Semler, 14 seconds here. Forrest drops AW, comes out from behind, takes down Pronex. Crims alone, 9 seconds, and he can't stop the bomb plant.
That shot there was crucial for Crims. If he hit that, he won the round. If he missed it, this is what happens. Forrest will get another frag. That's four for him total in this round. But that was a shot that Crims, I mean, it was an opportunity. If he hits it, he wins the round for Fnatic. But unfortunately for him, he just couldn't quite react in time. Olofmeister also with an impressive performance there. I mean, I like to see it that we actually have the ops split up as well. One on A, one on B. A lot of the time we've been seeing the ops, you know, double op on A, right? That's the go-to setup, but Fnatic already changing it up, trying to catch Nip off guard and really make them wonder exactly how Fnatic are going to be setting up each round.
Now they're actually going to be an eco Fnatic here, and they're moving up quite aggressively, but Get Right going to dispatch of two of them quickly. And Freiburg down to, Freiburg also picking up Pronax here, so this eco round, not really much of an effect, but I think I like the fact that Fnatic actually tried to make something of it and try to see if they can catch NIP off guard.
I mean, you're talking about a minimal investment here on Fnatic's part. If they can actually catch anybody with those CZs up close like that, they are lethal. And they only need to get a couple kills here to have this be an effective eco as far as Fnatic are concerned. Flusha still waiting right around the angle, just makes it, but Exist is going to peek out, and there you go. This is what we're talking about. Flusha, instant kill on Exist. And that's an excellent trade as far as he's concerned. He's got $300 on him. He just took, what, $4,500 off of Exist. That's a perfect play there for Fnatic.
Yeah, that's exactly how the maths work. Now, Olofmeister's pushing up behind. Would be great if he could catch a kill, but he's actually stomping quite a bit here, thunderfooting away, and he's going to be going down. Fiflaren, not even really sure why, but somehow he ended up in the right place at the right time, and that's just how it works out. So that is going to be equalizing the score here. 3-3, moving into the seventh round. Already, I would say, NIP with a really good adjustment. From what we've seen so far, it seems like you can make do with about six rounds or so in the first half. On the terrorist side, that
is. Oh, yeah. Yeah, six rounds would be great, I think, actually, for Nip. If they could get that down, that would be fantastic. We have seen this turn into quite a CT-sided map. So, Nip, with this strong start, the ability to bounce back here after Fnatic take the initial three rounds is huge for them. And just like we were saying, I mean, a clutch win in that fourth round bye for them really set them on the right path. Nip are now the team to stop here. Fnatic, no fancy weapons for them. It's only going to be Colts across the board with some nades.
Right now, Fnatic holding with just a single person in the middle with that drop zone. And that's actually something NIP haven't gone for yet. So Fnatic gotta make sure they stay awake and really keep you up to date there, because if they get a little bit complacent, if they get defocused here in the middle, that's gonna be a big problem. Mm-hmm. They gotta, you know, they're a little bit worried. You can see actually they're moving Crimson here, because the longer it takes when NIP aren't hitting that, they keep thinking, well, eventually, probably something's gonna happen here. And it's all about guessing the right round at this point.
It's gonna be Forrest actually manning the AWP, takes a shot, manages to clip JW, drops him down to 20 HP. So that's going to force Fnatic actually into a bit of a rotation. Get right instantly looking to apply pressure here. There's a man on his left. He flicks in time. He could get two, but he's not going to make it. Pronex will shut him down, brings it back to a 4-on-4, and Freiburg will not find it. Pronex with two huge kills for Fnatic.
Yeah, that was a big miss by Freiburg. Now they're pushing into the bomb site. Flush us right here. This is where we saw Forest hold yesterday. He's going to push up with the M4. Takedown exists. It's looking really good for Fnatic. Flusher with a double kill as well. Forest alone going to get backstabbed. And a great round from Fnatic. Pulls it home. They only lose JW. But the fact is, that could have been a disastrous round for Fnatic. Mm. If Pronex goes down to Freiburg, all of a sudden, it's almost no way Flusher can hold the bombsite any longer.
He gets cut up, exactly. It's crossfire town for Nip at that point, and they can just roll onto that site. Flusher in a very precarious position, really. He was able to get the drop on one man, but that is a very popular spot to be holding from. So you can be sure that Nip are, or should be at least, trying to clear it consistently when they make a play for that site. We'll have to see how effective it is in the future, but now, because of that round, Fnatic are able to buy up an AWP now for JW.
And look at the absolute nerve on JW. He actually, again, walks past the smoke and double scopes up towards the sniper nest. If anyone else is out in that courtyard and they're looking towards him, he can't see a thing. I have no idea how he has the nerve to do this in a grand finals for $100,000 at first place.
I love how there's a little bit of symmetry here. This time it's JW tagging Forrest down to, 20 HP or so. So JW almost getting caught in that corner as well. Nip missing a bit of an opportunity to get the punish. But this is still anybody's round. In fact, Nip still moving around. I mean, they've only really left Forrest over towards a slope like this, trying to set up and see if he can catch anybody rotating through. Once his teammates start to make noise on B, this is going to be the center of attention right here.
This is actually what they've been doing almost every round, except the last one where they did end up trying to go to A and didn't work. So I guess NIP just decided, look, B bombsite just seems to be working better for us. Can they get the right entry kill here? I think that's the key. Olofmeister waiting in yet a new position. This broken wall, as Steel's calling it. And he's going to pick up the first kill here on Flaren. Freiburg goes down. Olofmeister pistols out, almost gets the third one, but it doesn't even matter. The rest of his team is there to step it up. And that's a completely solid hold from Fnatic and a really good adjustment here for the counter-terrorist side.
Very solid. I mean, you pointed it out, but that's a great position there for Olofmeister to be holding. He's really making Nip guess, because you see, Nip are trying to adjust to Olofmeister. That's why they throw that Molotov there, to make sure that he can't be hiding behind that angle. He was so dangerous with that AWP in the round before. So now they throw that Molly, but Olofmeister, he's one step ahead of Nip. He's already changed it up. So a very solid hold there by Fnatic. Olofmeister holding them at that point means that the rotation comes in with the rest of the defense, and they're able to set up the crossfire and just obliterate Nip. So Nip now down to pistols again. 4 CZs and 1 P250. Freiburg a purist.
So just when it was looking like maybe NIP was going to take control of the game already in the first half here, and this is Fnatic's map pick, they bounce right back on the Fnatic lineup here. Drop zone, going to be nothing but bodies falling down from the sky there as Fiflaren and Forrest are left. And Crims and the crew are just going to pick it up easily. JW can hear someone running here, jumps up, and actually a little bit dangerous. Knife is out as well. It's going to be a no scope for JW. A little bit of style points as well in that kill. Can he pick up Forrest as well? Be nice if they could not lose any rifles here, and they won't. So great play from Fnatic. That builds up their economy, their confidence, and also, NIP realize now they have a lot more to do here. A lot of money. Look at this Fnatic scoreboard right now. 9,000 on Pronex. JW with about 7,000 and 8,000 on Crims. Looking really smart.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this is now Nip starting to lose a little bit of control here in this round, because they really are going to have to win two back-to-back buy rounds against Fnatic before they can really get Fnatic down to that point where they're going to have to start questioning themselves. Do they eco or do they force? Nip now, it's going to be a long slog for them. They needed to maintain the momentum and keep Fnatic on the back foot, but JW is not interested in that at all. Picks off Get Right to start, giving his team the advantage in this defense.
Flusher all the way by the A bomb site, spotting a couple of people, and JW rotates back in. He's so mobile. Every round he's been over by A long, and then one round he just picks it up, goes to the B bomb site and goes super aggressive. There's no way in hell NIP could have guessed that was going to happen, and they've only lost two people because of it. So right now JW is doing a hell of a lot to work out this win for Fnatic. Pronex comes up with a headshot as well, and it's Forrest and Flaren left here, and they're not even getting any kills right now.
It's at that point they're pinned down. They just can't get in. Forrest would have had to have landed some sick headshots for that to actually work there for Nip, but it's going to be the rush down.
They wanted to knife him.
Yeah, I think they did want to set up for that. I mean, Fnatic are really. I think this is all like no holds barred right now. There are no lines that need to be crossed or anything like that. They have no respect. It's just going to be, we are going to grind you into the dust right from the start. Nip, Fnatic, this is all about ending this 2-0, not letting it go to a third map.
Yeah, and actually, I think it might be even worse. I think it's actually on NIP to end this 2-0 because that third map's Inferno. And I'm not sure if Fnatic, I think I would favor Fnatic on Inferno against NIP right now. But that's obviously going to come down to the test here. JW up in that window room in the middle, and obviously it's an eco round from NIP, so there's not really much they can do here. But again, right now NIP aren't even accomplishing to pick up rifles from Fnatic, which means once they start winning again, they're going to need to win so many consecutive rounds. It's going to be really tough.
Oh, and this is a brutal beat down here. Flush is somehow controlling the spray to get more. And he even shoots his teammate in the side of the head. Careful there. Get right. We'll find Crims. So at least there's one kill for Nip. They're going to force Fnatic to spend a little bit of money in the next round. But that's not good enough right now for Nip. Nip need these rounds, these eco rounds for themselves, to be a bit closer, a bit more effective. They need to be taking 2-3 rifles off of Fnatic to really have an impact on their money. But still, I mean, JW with the spot at mid, and basically Flush is setting it up perfectly to gun them down. A very quick, clean round there for Fnatic. And now we go into the 12th round. Fnatic with 8 rounds to Nip's 3.
Yeah, they've won the last 5 in a row on the Fnatic lineup, so it's looking really good. Again, JW just pushing out here and scoping up. I really am impressed by the confidence it takes to do this kind of work, because if someone's down there looking by the fountain outside or the statue or whatever it is, he's definitely going to be going down very quickly. And again, a different kind of setup here, as JW is down in the middle, going to be taking out Fiflaren. They just can't guess where he is. And as a result, how are you going to smoke or flash someone out if you don't know where they are? Because you can't smoke off everywhere on Cobblestone. There are so many pathways. No. That's not an option.
It's just not possible. And I feel like this really just plays to JW's strengths. Great kill there by Get Right, though. Catches Pronax pushing in. He saw the flash go by. He knew exactly what was happening. But Olfmeister, with the control of mid, is already going to get the flank going. Exist Freiburg down, but Get Right strikes. He's going to pick it up and bring it into a 1v3, but he's kind of caught in a box at this point. Crims is cutting off the access to B site, and there are 2 Fnatic members on that A site. So Get Right, this is the best case scenario for him here. If he could find this kill instantly on Crims. And he is looking towards the right angle, but now there's just too many places for him to be checking. He turns around to check the site proper, and that's going to be it. Get Right getting caught. Fnatic now with 9 rounds on the board.
And that was actually a bit of a mistake on NIP's part, because once they got into drop zone, that was really, really, that was a nice execution. But what happened afterwards was that Get Right was going on the upstairs, and they actually went down the window to the right-hand side. And if they had timed that perfectly, they would have peeked out both sides at the same time. But 2 of them ran out, and Get Right wasn't able to get into position in time. So I think they could have definitely done that better in NIP. Now Get Right's up here, and is JW going to do it again? He's walking out, he's scoping up, and Get Right gets the better of the Star Sniper on Fnatic's lineup here. So that's a pretty good investment, and I think that position from Get Right was based on his spawn. Mm-hmm. He spawned close to that sniper tower, and he said, I'm going to go for it.
Hell, I wouldn't even be surprised to see him swap that rifle with somebody else now at this point. Head it over to Forest, get an AK. But Nip now actually have the entry going for them. It's the first big advantage that they've had in quite some time. So we have to see how they decide to play this out, because Get Right got that kill so early. They still have more than a minute left on this clock to start working around the map and seeing if they can get another pick. Nip really with the advantage going into this at this point.
Freiburg, Fnatic, look at this. Freiburg actually with a practice smoke there. This is a set strategy from NIP. That's definitely some homework coming into it here. And wow. They're going to smoke off the right-hand side of the entrance into the B-bomb site. Olofmeister, grenade going to do some damage here, and actually does a fair bit of damage to Forrest. Can they take Olof? He's in the middle of everything. He gets taken out by Exist. Now Pronax has to hold the bomb site. Still 35 seconds. Can they deal with it? They will deal with it. It's Freiburg again. Crims and Flusher are both here. They got to get in quick, but there's still a band backstabbing. Flusher takes down Freiburg. Where's the teamwork for NIP?
Oh, they have to realize that there's another man on here, and they're looking for him. They're expecting Crims to really push forward. I don't know why Crims is throwing his guns out there, maybe trying to bait a shot out, but he is going to get naded down to half HP. This is still a 2-on-2 situation, and Nip need to find a way past because they're out of nades. They no longer have any way to cut these members off for Fnatic. 10 seconds left, but Get Right strikes, takes out Flusha, and just in the nick of time, Nip will find the plant. Now it's an impossible situation here for Crims. Too many spots to check at this point. They can set up the afterplants for Nip.
They should be able to. Not really the guy you normally expect to go out sniping here, Get Right, but he's already got the double. Hey, he's gonna pick up that triple. Get Right with the AWP. That is a rare sight. And the few times that we have seen it, it's actually been pretty awful, but this time it was absolutely what they needed. The first pick on JW, and then they got into the site And I was just about to scold NIP because what it looked like to me was they had the entrance into B, they had Get Right down in the middle, he could have backstabbed them, and it looked like that was going to be the perfect move. And then he decided, nope, I'm just going to walk in and take them out instead.
We're going to take this fight straight up. Flusha with his rotation also giving the opportunity there for NIP to actually get past because Crims had to hold so passively. So NIP really just managing to make it work, played patiently, didn't try and rush anybody down. They just tried to play for the time and got it done. Get Right, however, now once again out in mid, and he's looking to see if he can't find exactly where JW is hiding this time around. Looking towards the window, looking towards the apartments, but JW in turn is playing fairly passively this time on his own side.
He's taking up a new angle at every single time. If you compare all the 14 rounds we've had so far, 13 rounds, you'll see that JW hasn't... He might have been in the same place three rounds later, but there's no two consecutive rounds where he's exactly in the same spot. And that is really frustrating for NIP right now. They've found him, and that's half the battle right now. At least they know he's on this side of the map.
That's true, and they do know that that A apartments, of course, is going to be the highly contested spot for that A bomb site, because as you can see, either you go down through the ramp, which is wide open, and you don't want to be running at JW across wide open ground, or you try and push through the apartments. But JW and Wolfmeister both have those AWPs, but they have been split up again. There's Flusha managing to strike and pick off Forrest, who was working up that ramp, and now Fnatic have to prepare the defense here for the B push.
Yeah, Olofmeister been boosted up here. In fact, it's a really great position. He's going to fall back down to safety, but not quick enough for Freiburg, who picks up the headshot. Crims got to stay alive here. He can just wait, hold back here for teammates to come in. It should be all right, but he goes down through the smoke. Get Right will pick up the kill, and I think a big mistake on Crims's part here. 8 seconds now, and they got to get this bomb down. Flush just rushing up. Trying to see if he can stop it. He's going to pick up the one. 4 seconds left, and it's a one-on-one, and they can't put the bomb down. Flush just going to survive the round, and NIP will run out of time and lose it. And now Flusha. If he gets this kill, that's going to be even worse.
Now Fry backing off. Freiburg will get the kill on Flusha. He stays alive, and that was so important. But Get Right, I think he actually got caught on the wall trying to make the jump up to that site. And with so little time, there was no time to go for a rejump, right, for a second try. And really just NIP playing it down to the wire. But once again, Freiburg, individual play, I think, is what's really determining this here for NIP, whether they get these rounds or not. Freiburg again able to get multiple kills and just clear up the defense, because Fnatic were ready. They were prepared. They had already rotated a guy over from that B side, or from that A side rather, to make sure that NIP weren't getting through. And somehow, once again, NIP, with the help of Freiburg, stormed the site. They just need to do it with another 10 seconds, basically, to work with. If they could time it so they have another 10 seconds, then that bomb does go down.
Nice pickup from JW. Takes out one of the few players who didn't have a rifle here. The other three do have AKs. We're in the 15th round, and NIP, I'm not sure 4 is enough to work with. I think a minimum is actually 5. 4-11 would be a really ridiculous comeback from NIP if they could do that in the second half. I believe the magic number they're looking for here is 5. They do have a couple of AKs to work with, and even a few smokes, so they can still execute here. But I think right now, what they've been doing for a lot of rounds is also very, should we say, expected for Fnatic, because they put Forest somewhere with a bomb site, and then everyone else goes B. So as soon as they find Forest, that's almost an instant tell that probably everyone else is going to be a B.
NIP really showing that this is the bomb site that really worked on, clearing everything. Pronax waiting in his little corner. This is the Pronax spot. Just spraying, and he gets it with the near final shot. Pronax with a headshot on Freiburg, clears it up, but they do manage to strike back. NIP, the flank comes in from Crimson. He can't do it. Get Right gets him first, and this is now just exist alive, but not for long. Olofmeister removes him from the map, and it will be an 11-4 finish at the end of the first half. Fnatic with an excellent performance on their CT side. This is definitely doable here going into the second half for Fnatic.
I absolutely agree. They did pick the map as well, so you gotta wonder if they have either been studying a little bit or secretly preparing, or whichever way you like it. Either way, they do have a really, really good first half. And
come on, Forrest. Easy skins, easy life. He needs to make it happen. I wanna see Forrest grin. We need the Forrest troll grin.
Well, maybe that's gonna happen if they end up winning. If not, I'm not really sure. NIP, this
is... Oh, there it is! Somebody printed it out! Awesome! I'm loving the posters so far.
Third major in a row that they've managed to make it to the grand finals, and they've lost the last two. First time it was to Fnatic, second time it was to Versus Pro. This time they're up against Fnatic again with a slightly different lineup, but look, that's not even... The really interesting thing is that part of that old lineup is still here in Devil Walk, who's behind them. One of the guys who helped to beat NIP the first time around. So if anyone has, you know, that little extra bit of insight, knows a little bit about the patterns they play in, how they might react to a certain situation, Definitely Devil Walk could be that man.
Now, Devil Walk is the man that I mean, it's so fitting for him to be the coach as well, because even knowing exactly how Fnatic interacted as players, right, before the change, before the roster change, Devil Walk was like kind of the older brother makes father of the team. You know, everybody would go to him for guidance. He would be the one to keep everybody together, solving any kind of arguments, problems that ever came up. Like, that, this team would not have held together if it weren't for Devil Walk. So it really is fitting to have him as the coach, because the players all trust him. He is their go-to figure. But Olaf Meister and Krims coming into this team has really been such a strong addition. I mean, you heard the news and you gasped, right? You know, Schneider and Devil Walk off Fnatic. This is incredible. And they bring in Olaf Meister and Krims, but it's only been a good thing here for Fnatic. I mean, obviously, they're sitting once again in a final for a major.
Yeah, and with a fairly newly minted lineup. But if you look at the history, though, that's exactly what happened when Pronax was added to Fnatic. They got to play one tournament. That was the MSI tournament in Beijing, China. And then they went straight into DreamHack and won it. They had about a week and a half to play with that lineup, and they won the first major tournament. So there is something that Pronax is able to do, and that's also what Sean Gares was talking about during our analyst panel here. Now, it's going to be the second half coming up. So once again, welcome Fnatic and NIP. Best of three, and this is the first map, second half, so you're just on time.
Look at how they're really trying to sneak in here, Fnatic. They want to get as many bodies as close as possible to really take this by surprise. Everybody goes thundering down, but Force is going to get one. Get Right here with the CZ gets two. Two headshots for Get Right, and he stops the push cold. It's into a 2-on-4, and Fnatic looking to get the edge on Nip and catch him by surprise. Completely flounder.
That was almost like a build order loss for Fnatic. NIP really had a good setup to deal with this. I still think it's a really cool idea for Fnatic, because if NIP just have the one man holding here, that's going to be a perfect entry. But Forest and Get Right both, and especially Get Right at that range with the CZ, not at all bad. But this is not over yet. Olaf Meister has picked up a USPS, and he's going to try and see if he can snipe someone in this B bomb site. 40 seconds is a problem, and the bomb is also dropped in there. But 2-on-4.
Well, they still have 40 seconds. That's the important bit here. If it was 20 seconds, 15 seconds, this would be an impossible situation for Fnatic. But at least they still have a little bit of time to hunt for the frags. But just Nip holding so passively right now is key. Freiburg staying alive, that is it as well. And this is going to be the end. Krims gets caught, and Nip will pick up the pistol round here in the second half. It was crucial that they do so, and they do it in very fine fashion.
And a round like that really makes me think, and we can't really test this except if we ask Pronox afterwards, if he actually went for the idea of, you know, he just looked at the games that NIP had played and thought, all right, previous rounds in the eco, they've been having just a single person there. So you know, I'm going to hope that they do the same thing. And NIP maybe didn't. We're going to have to go back and test that. But now
we're
in the 17th round.
By getting into it, you know that Pronax was definitely taking notes when Nip were playing LDLC. I mean, we've seen plenty of games from Nip on this map versus Cloud9 versus the whole lot. So really, you know that Pronax has a lot of information to go off of, but that's the power of Nip. They're able to change up their game at will. They've made the adjustments necessary. They're playing Pronax, and Pronax is playing into their hands, really. So good kill coming in here from Olaf Meister. Get Right will manage to nade him into oblivion, however, and Fifflaren finds one as well. Get Right looking to use that Pro 90. Disgusting weapon. But Flesha. Yeah,
I'm still not really a fan of him picking it up, but actually on this map, he has made it work a couple of times, so who am I to question it?
There's another thing
here that really comes into this as well when it comes to trying to Andy Strat on a map that nobody really knows how to play, which is that NIP, if they realize, okay, Pronax has been looking at how we play, let's try and change it up. How many go-to strats do they really have? This isn't like on Nuke or Dust2 or something. You could go years back and say, okay, well, actually, maybe NIP could go years back and think, does anyone remember any kind of cobblestone strat from 1.6 we can pull out? But other than that, they just have a few weeks where they've been looking at it, and that doesn't leave them with much.
No, not at all, and not half that time. Just like half a week to really apply, I mean, practice anything at all on this map. We are seeing Nip evolve live here on this map. They're going into each official match, and they're getting better each and every time when they come out of them. So this is why Nip are the most consistent team in the world. This is why every team fears them. Their ability to just adapt on the spot. Forrest will find JW up in A apartments. There's still a second man here, but not for long. Fifflaren with a great headshot, 5-7 in hand. He has yet to upgrade to a rifle as well. But that 5-7 is lethal, and Exist is getting dropped down, but Get Right's got the Pro 90. Fnatic back off. They don't want any of that.
I love this double hold from NIP. I think it's such a good idea having two people here towards the drop zone. Olaf Meister goes down as well, and it's a round where actually NIP don't lose a single person. Freiburg will be very low on health here right now, and this should be a huge concern for Fnatic. It's Get Right top fragging with 19 kills. And once Get Right is fired up and up and running, and we saw how he reacted to the victory against LDLC, once he's on point, really, really terrible things can happen to your team.
And talking about Get Right, you know, he's been very inconsistent, actually, showing some of his lowest performances in his CSGO career in recent months. So for him to come in strong into this Grand Finals and top frag here, that's going to give him a huge boost of confidence. And you're definitely right. That is going to be a very sad time for Fnatic if Get Right really gets on a roll, because that'll boost the rest of his teammates along with him, Freiburg, Forest, and then Nip become that monster, that Godzilla of CSGO, that is just unstoppable.
Now from that first half, 11-4, now all of a sudden we're at 11-7, and it's only a four-round difference. That doesn't seem like so much, but Fnatic can take a big leap forward here by winning this round and breaking down NIP's economy a little bit. Two in a row, and Fnatic almost have this map, so it isn't as bad as it seems here. NIP, they're closing in, but Fnatic can still take it.
Absolutely. They have got full buy right now going into it, so we have to see exactly how they're going to make use of these nades. I mean, we can see Flusha setting up right now. Thank you, Vendetta. And we are going to see exactly where this smoke is going to go down. It's a similar one to the one that Freiburg went for, exactly. Blocking off that spot onto the B site so that the crossfire becomes more difficult, and it forces rotations out of Nip. They have to actually change up their angle to cover this site effectively now that those smokes are down. But hey, Forrest doesn't have any problem with that. Two kills for him in the blink of an eye.
Yeah, and they fell into the drop zone again, and the double hold for NIP really seems to be effective here. If you found spots, one person down the middle, that's frustrating. Actually, Fnatic have decided we're going to go for an A push, and I think part of this A push was actually the people jumping down into the middle. So now that they're gone, it doesn't work as well. It's kind of a pincer where one half is missing, and JW coming in a 1-on-4 here. The bomb is dropped in the middle. There's only 10 seconds, and he's going to go down. Forrest, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's almost an ace. It's very, very close here. And it's going to be 8-11. Forrest jumping up to 14 kills in this round.
Yeah, Forrest is just everywhere, and that's what I'm talking about. If Get Right gets rolling, Forrest isn't far behind. Freiburg as well, sitting with 12-1-12. These are the three heavy hitters here for Nip. I mean, exist as well, but they're, you know, the thing is that right now, these three players, they're being very greedy. They aren't interested in sharing it all with their teammates. Fifarin and Exist sitting at 4 frags, but that's not a problem if Nip are winning the rounds. Fnatic now sitting on a pistol round again. They have to eco. They aren't able to get the bomb plant, and that's a crucial point to be made here. That bonus $800 could make all the difference for Fnatic and get them those guns, but it's not going to be the case. Get Right changing up the angle yet again.
And Exist changing the frag score there, up to 5 now. Freiburg goes down to Pronax. That's a really good pistol kill coming in here, but they should be able to stabilize, and it's going to be a round where planning the bomb again will be very difficult here. Pronax made it to the bomb site, but he forgot the bomb, so that is not exactly an ideal situation.
I mean, look at the, actually how it's breaking down for Fnatic right now. Everybody very consistent across the board. Olafmeister with 18 sitting at the top, and that really just goes to show he is the man who makes things happen for Fnatic. Flusha and Krims right behind him. Pronax and JW not too far behind. So, I mean, really, everybody's playing fairly consistently here on Fnatic's side. Now it's just a matter of them figuring out exactly what Nip are changing in their defense, because you know that Pronax right now, it's going through his head exactly what are the changes, how do we adapt to them, and how do we take advantage of this.
Well, it must be a source of really big frustration if you think you've got a team figured out from watching them just play, then you get in the map and they switch it up just maybe enough that it's not going to work any longer. Can you actually then make a counter adjustment? I think that's an even harder task than the one NIP was faced with, but an opening pick is an opening pick, and that goes for any map. JW, he gives them one onto the top fragger here, one of the top fraggers, which is Forest. Get Right is still alive, of course, and it's a good start for a Fnatic.
And this really works for Fnatic as well. Now we have to see exactly where they take the bomb, and it is shaping up to be a bit of an A play here. Four guys gathering towards that A slope with JW on high, watching their backs with that AWP, and Fnatic gearing up for this push. Nip, they have gone for the rotation to bolster the defense here. Get Right is now covering with Fiflarin. But Fiflarin, this is going to be a crucial shot. He needs to land it instantly. As soon as he sees them coming up the slope, he has to drop that man. And there you go. He spots JW first. Fiflarin coming out ahead for Nip.
How did nobody see each other? It looked like they were just scoped up against each other for such a long time. That's a huge kill. Get Right picks up one and gets a second one. Can he get third? Not quite. But Fiflarin is there with a quick double end. It will be Pronax left. 1-on-3, and the clock is ticking down here. 19, 18 seconds. If he could get the bomb plant, that would give Fnatic so much more money. But Fiflarin with a triple kill. And that's about time that Robin Johansson steps it up, and he will do it. Now, outfragging Exist. And you are right, because Fiflaren and Nexus, they're low up on the scoreboard, and in match against LDLC on this very map, Fiflaren had a long stretch where he killed absolutely nobody, mm-hmm. and it nearly cost NIP the game. So if he can step it up even 10%, that could be all that NIP need.
It could be all that it takes, and Getright doing a very good job there setting it up. That 1-2 combination defense on A site. Fiflaren peaks, draws the attention, Getright gets a frag. Getright peaks, draws the attention, Fiflaren takes a man out. So the defense there working very well here. Nip now having to shut down Fnatic once again, who have managed to put together a respectable buy. Quite a few nades to work with, but Fiflaren waiting up in A-Apps decides to back off, and that single smoke should stop the push here from Fnatic. They won't be able to rush through.
Really dangerous the close that they were with that AWP. I really want him to go back and take a longer distance here. So he's going to do that, so that's a really, really smart move, I think, from Fiflaren. Now they only have AK, so this time he doesn't have to deal with JW's AWP, but can he still get the kills up in the back here? JW peeks out and there's a firing squad waiting. They take him down through that wood panel. Forrest with the headshot right through, and has come Crimson. He's gonna pick up the one, the two. Can they do more than that? They need more. Fiflaren picks up one, no scope, misses, and it's a 2-on-2. Fnatic have a chance here. They need to pick up this round. They gotta do it. They've lost so many in order. They've not won a single round in the second half. Now is the time for it.
Yeah.
38 seconds, and Freiburg is in a really good position. He's covering the bomb. They have to pick it up, get into the bomb site without losing a single member here, and that in itself is not an easy task. In fact, I think they want to go and try and see if they can make a 2-on-1 before they do it. Flash pops in and Nexus is down. Great play from Pronex. Tactical genius here. Now Freiburg is going to be walking around. That bomb is down, and Freiburg looking for a way to equalize the situation. He's going to be walking up, spots Pronex here in the corner, takes him down, turns around for the 180, still 15 bullets left. Freiburg launches it, are you kidding? It's going to be a double. He does it again and again and again.
And there's nothing to be said, really. Speechless that Freiburg manages to pull it off. I mean, really, walking in there, and you already saw he knew exactly where the second man would be, where Flusher would be holding from, trying to control the spray, does the 180, but keeps his cool. Fnatic and Ninjas in Pajamas both have ice in their veins. For Pronex to slow down the pace and turn it into the 2v1 in the first place, he knew how much time they had. He knew he could get the advantage for his team, but then individual performance once again strikes, and we do have Nip actually managing to even things up here. It is now 11-11. Nip with the advantage going into it. Still with the money and quite a bit of as well on Fiflaren and Exist both. They have no worries here. They can keep the pressure ratcheted up against Fnatic.
Because we luckily don't know how this game is gonna end, we can't really call the MVP yet, but at this point, Freiburg is in the lead by miles and miles and miles. I have no idea how it is even possible for one person to clutch that many rounds in a single tournament.
He has been the MVP. It's pretty clear at this point. If Nip were to take the entire thing, he gets the vote. And that is going, there's no discussion there. The number of times that he's saved Nip's bacon. Fnatic, they have to know this as well. And there may be a tremor there, but then again, it is fitting for it to be Fnatic, or Freiburg rather, versus Flusha in a 1v1. The clutch players for both teams, and Flusha as well, which was said earlier, you know, one of the highest, basically, statistically speaking, at least earlier in the year, the best clutcher in the world. So for Freiburg to take him out, that's not a bad statement. And once again, Nip are going to be shattering Fnatic's confidence. This timeout, I think, is basically them trying to slow down the pace.
Well, there was a PC issue, actually. So they get a bit of a free timeout, which is definitely great for Fnatic. They need it. I think you're right, though. That was a soul-shattering round, because the move that Pronex did, the decision to say, the normal play would say, let's focus on getting the bomb down, and then the pressure is on the counter-terrorists. They're going to try and come and we'll pick them off. And Pronex decided, no, wait, let's make it a 2-on-1 instead. I'll just flash in with a perfect flashbang, godlike flashbang, and takes down Exist and puts them in a 2-on-1, and Freiburg still takes it away. That is something that really cuts deep into Fnatic's mentality right here. And this pause could really help them.
Yeah, I mean, this is really, it actually couldn't happen at a worse time. I mean, if this is not a pause, if they're just resetting, I mean, this could not happen at a worse time for Nip, because this is the moment when you want to actually just continue.
Oh, look at Forrest, flirting with the
What's
camera.
Up, Forrest? This is when you want to keep pushing. You don't want Fnatic to have time to catch their breath. You want to keep that pressure on. So Nip need to keep it up on Fnatic right now and not let them get that second breath. Fnatic actually putting quite a bit of pressure early on here. They want to catch that first step on Nip, getting out onto this B site so quickly here. This is now going to break down. I mean, we're following Olaf Meister. He's completely blind at this point. Switching to JW, gets a double mow down. Freiburg and Exist cleared up. But then Fifth Lauren comes into play with the AWP, takes out Flusha, and brings it back to a 4-on-3. Fnatic will be able to get the plant, as I say it. And now the countdown begins. Nip are on a clock. They have to find a way to root the Fnatic defense out of here because the tables have turned. It's now Nip that are invading the site.
Fnatic have such great positions. Pronax holding back right here is really good. Trusting in his teammates to get the bomb down. JW close. Actually, Flaren takes him down. Pronax jumps down, but I think they've heard it. Get right as he takes him down. What's going on? Fnatic have the advantage, but not anymore. Now it's Olaf Meister and Krims left. 2-on-2. Krims goes down. Olaf Meister on 2 HP. Runs out with a knife, and they get the round anyway. There's no time. No, there is. Oh, what? In the last seconds, they get the defuse. I can't believe it. It looked like Olaf Meister thought that was going to be over too. He just charged him with the knife out.
Yeah, that was one of those split-second defuses, and it went the right way this time. Nip actually coming out ahead with the retake, and just in the nick of time, make it happen. Freiburg raising his arms and shouting at the crowd. I mean, that's a monster right there that you do not want to wake up. If Freiburg joins the Get Right and Forest party, this is going to be very sad here for Fnatic. But Fnatic, they get that plant, they have to keep their cool. Because of that plant, that bonus 800 for everybody, they can get a very respectable buy-in here and just keep hammering at Nip. They have to find a way to break the confidence that the other Swedish team has developed here.
I don't think anyone is going to be joining Get Right right now. He's at 27 kills. That's at the very least 9 ahead of anyone else in this game. That's completely monstrous. This is the rebirth of Get Right, because he's really not been playing his own game. This has been a topic all tournament long, just what a slump Get Right's been in. But he's somehow managed to recover himself just when it matters the most. The perfect time to peak in the whole tournament has to be in the grand finals.
Exactly, that's the thing. Of all the times to have your star performance, it is now in the first map on Cobble that Fnatic have picked to mess with your heads. And Nip, they're responding magnificently right now. Fnatic are hard pressed, but Get Right trying to, well, actually catch them off guard here with a bit of an aggressive flash into a peek. Fnatic, they don't flinch. 30 seconds left, and now they're actually going to start feeling the pressure here. Fnatic have to go for this. They don't have any time. They have to overwhelm the defense immediately, but Nip are playing this so perfectly. They fall all the way back to the edges of the site. They're going to hold so passively from here on out and try and just do their best to burn time off the clock to force Fnatic into a tight spot.
Freiburg, that double spray down sealed the deal. There is nothing Fnatic could do any longer after that. Olaf Meister's going to charge in here, but the time is going to end it. In fact, Get Right with a headshot pushes himself up now to 29 kills. He's one away from dropping a 30 bomb with just 24 rounds on played here on Cobblestone. This setup from NIP is very, very different from the one they had when they played earlier in the tournament against Cloud9, I believe.
Sure.
Then, what they did is they had Exist in the low ground back towards the guard spot that we managed to determine. And that was something we actually pointed out when I was casting the steel. This is something we talked about quite a bit during that game, is that, well, if he just moved up to the back, it'd be way better. And it seems like NIP have figured out exactly the same thing. So that's a really big adjustment.
You can be sure that they were. You can be sure that they were doing their homework yesterday and today, and especially after the LDLC match. They had 20 minutes, but Nip found the time to adjust. Fnatic are the ones reeling now. And Fnatic are actually running out of rounds now to work with here. Nip are on the favorite side of this map, and Fnatic just keep trying to break the line. But Nip, the confidence and the cool that they have right now under pressure is remarkable. Making the right call in the last round, playing the clock against Fnatic, and once again, Fnatic not able to find an entry frag. That's another thing that Nip have been very good about so far towards the end of this half. They aren't giving Fnatic any kind of way in, really, to be able to get an easy way into a bomb site.
But if they can get this kill on Fiflaren, that might open it up, but it's not going to work out like that. Fiflaren imposing his will until Flusher will take him down, but Freiburg and Forrest and Exist is a team effort. Everyone chiming in. Flusher's going to be alone here. Gus get a headshot while flashed as well. It's a really impressive AK shot. And a second one. Nicely done, Flusher. Can we get a little bit more here? He's going to nearly spray down Forrest. It's so close. Flusher, an incredible clutcher. And he almost did that 1-on-4.
Look at Get Right's reaction as well. They knew just how close that was. Had Flusher picked that up, he was actually in a great position behind that boulder as well. He wouldn't have been gunned down immediately. That could have been a very, very close play. And of course, it's Flusher going for the clutch, nearly getting 3 frags. But now we approach the crunch time here. Nip on 14 rounds, one round away from securing match point in overtime at the least.
NiP have won 10 rounds in a row in this second half. Fnatic have nothing to show for it at all. Their terrorist strat or their attacks to these bomb sites, they've been failing every single round, and now they gotta make it work. If they lose this one, I'm not sure they can come back, and it will be Forest opening up. More grenades raining down in the middle. They gotta make a move on it here, but Get Right steps it up, and now Fnatic, what are they gonna do? They're 3-on-5. They gotta find a kill quick, but I'm not sure it's happening. Get Right will pick up a double end flush. Look at Forest, action style, jumping down, and that's gonna punish them.
That's gonna punish them. Exist missing a huge opportunity. Flusher, if he takes him out, this is over, but Exist makes it happen, and Olafmeister now caught at the bottom of the slope. The bomb on the other side of the wall. The wrong side of the wall, and he's only got 3 HP. He's trying to find a different angle, but Exist will find the frag, and NiP are now on match point 15-11, one round away from securing the first map in this best of three. You need two maps, and they're halfway. They're nearly halfway there. But I think that was actually a bit of a mistake there from NiP, really. I think They got a bit ahead of themselves, jumping down and giving Fnatic a way back into that round like that.
I completely agree, and it's not just a mistake because they lost all those people. It's a mistake to assume that you've won already. Fnatic can take four rounds and reinforce the overtime. That is definitely a possibility, and even then, there's still a whole new map, so you can't just take this for granted. But Exist will open up, sprays down one, Freiburg, and Freiburg again before he finally drops. Now it's a 2-on-3. They're running into the bomb site. I'm not sure Fnatic have any control of what's going on right now. They need smokes, they need flashbangs, they need to zone out the orbs that are looking into the bomb site here, put that on the bomb and defend it, but it's gonna take such a long time. And Fuflaren has really been stepping up his game here in the second half. He does miss the shot, but Forest will not. Now it's a 3-on-1, and ladies and gentlemen, it's gonna be NiP taking the first map away from Fnatic here in the grand final at ESL 1 Cologne. What an upset. This is the map that Fnatic picked.
Yeah, this was all Fnatic. This was all them here. And that was a perfect CT half from NiP. You can be sure that Fnatic felt confident going into this second half here that they had NiP figured out. But NiP, they surprised us all. And they will take the first map. They have the advantage going into the rest of this best of three. But let's go ahead and break down this game at the end analysis desk. All to you, Scoots.
Thank you very much, guys. The Room on Fire guys, they're doing an awesome job this weekend. You know, they started it for us. Gotta love Anderson Semler. But again, amazing stuff. It's too early to say if 4-11 is a good, okay side, bad side. You know, everyone says it's kind of like the old Cobble. It is CT-sided. But again, 12 straight rounds from the pistol on, and NiP secures themselves yet again. It's safe to say they are the best team playing Cobblestone on the planet.
Yep. Other than that Epsilon match, the first match they started off on Cobblestone, they have come back in rare form. They are epic. That was a performance made of, that's a champion for performance right there that we saw. We haven't seen NiP do something like that in the finals of a major yet. So I bet that takes a huge load off their shoulders, and I would be super scared going into this cash map if I were Fnatic right now.
It's got to be absolutely crushing for Pronax. I literally cannot express this enough. He's gambled here with this pick. Yeah. He said, we're going to play you on Cobble. We're confident. We've got strats. And it looked good, CT. They had it locked down. You know, it was a brick wall. 11-4 at half time. What have you got up your sleeve for terrorists? And it turned out that this guy that we've hyped up as a genius didn't have anything.
Yeah. Quite the Houdini right there, huh? He didn't really have anything there. So, I think the hugest round of the whole half right there was that Freiburg 1-2, yeah, where we all just kind of got out of our chair and happened?
We went crazy. So
he literally followed that guy right out the connector, fragged him, and then hit an amazing one shot on the guy's sight, who I don't know why, but people keep peeking him.
Yeah.
In that same scenario, Freiburg literally won against
don't
the last match.
Don't peek the Freiburg.
I don't get it.
I want to say, like, If NiP do go on to win this major, everyone on that team needs to drop down and just kiss the feet of Freiburg. Not just because of that clutch, because he did it on Cobble with the pistol against you guys. If you remember when you didn't check that corner on that eco round, the smartest player of the whole tournament. Sorry again to bring it up.
If
that didn't happen, they're out. They're already out. So Freiburg has really proven his class this tournament, and again, just what a player and what a team.
Yeah, that was definitely a half. That was amazing. I'm at a loss for words because they just absolutely dominated them. A wasn't open, B wasn't open, the drop down got slaughtered. Other than that Freiburg 1 versus 2, there wasn't even really a close round, I felt like.
No, you're right. I mean, and this is what's so deceptive about this Ninjas in Pyjamas team at the moment. What we're seeing is they'll typically have one bad half. They'll really get to the brink where they're out and you think they're done. This is it. They're done. And then they're not done. They just find this other gear. They find a way to win an eco, or they just pull off a crazy strat, or they buy a gun that no one else has ever bought before in competitive play and get a four-man with it. I mean, it's such an incredible story. If they go on to win this major now, playing as poorly as they have, just scraping by, it just makes no sense. I mean, I'm going to be lost for words for a change.
We all thought that NIP looked in really weak form early in the tournament, and there was a lot of posts on the forums really asking for heads.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. I mean, my skin.
It was brutal. So they've really bounced back, and they've proven why they are the team to beat in the CSGO scene.
I want to say as well, because we brought it up in the previous round when I was with MBK, good to see Fifflaren have a much improved game over the last bit of cobble, and that brings us nicely over to the stats. You can see Fifflaren, when he last played, it was 5-for-19 for him overall. So going 12-for-20 and getting off the bottom, I mean, that's good for him to do that in a final, and I hope people start maybe cutting him a bit more slack.
And literally, this is the picture-perfect scoreboard that probably NIP would want to see going into this final, is they want to see their star players get right in for us, just like that. 32-16. Oh, that's just that's dominant. Incredible.
We didn't even get around to talking about get right, but right from the start, that first pistol round when he just dropped down and got like three kills over the CZ. This is what he does. I mean, at the end of the day, he is that mad fragger, but to have consistently done it and now doing it in a major, it's great to see. He's just, you know, the god.
Yeah, he really is. He's always kind of lurking in the background. He really uses his teammates in an excellent way. And I don't mean that as in he's baiting, because he's not at all. It's planned. So he really knows how to use his teammates to the maximum capabilities and get the frags in the easiest ways possible.
I've talked to Nip about this as well. Yeah. What they do is they distract. They fire guns and people peek the wrong way, and then just the timing is perfect. Exactly. Get right comes and gets the wraparound frags.
Exactly. It's not baiting at all. What it is just excellent Counter-Strike. It's top level.
We saw Pronax at the bottom there. Mentally, what do you think he's thinking going into this now? Because I don't know if his team, you say they trust him unconditionally, but, and I don't want to labor the point, but has he, you know, are they thinking, well, you said we were going to win this, dude?
Yeah. I don't know if what his teammates are feeling like, but I know from a leading perspective that getting blanked in a half like that, that really shakes your confidence in your own decisions, because you know he went into that match feeling very confident about his calls. He just saw NIP play Cobblestone 3-4 times this tournament. He's really confident in what they do on their CT sides, and he knows counters to it. None of the counters worked. So what does that do to his psyche right now going into cash, which is a map that they're already weak at? So I really hope that he lets his players play with free rein here. I'd like to see Olafmeister bust out the AWP with JW, maybe get an auto sniper floating around cash, because that's a really deadly gun to have on the CT side of cash.
And you know, and you segued without me even segueing. We're just going to switch seats here eventually. let's move forward. Let's move forward to the next map. And you know, before we get into the breakdown of the players and the teams on the map, you know, I know that Valve obviously has gotten a lot of grief about, you know, the kind of push of these two new maps, Overpass and Cobblestone, into the scene, right? And they have very valid reasons why they're doing it, you know, but we kind of beat that all to death. You know, we're not necessarily fans of the timing of it without the maps being kind of tweaked for professional play. Yeah. Opposite side of the coin is the cash map has been worked through their system slowly but surely, through the operation system, and now has become an official, everybody who owns the game gets to play cash. And it's one of my favorite new maps. It is such a rock solid map. And obviously, you get a guy like Volcano involved in a map.
Yeah.
Ex-huge pro in his own right. The cash guy, as he's now called, right?
No,
it's like, you don't know who Sal was before that? Shame on you, right? Great guy. So, you know, let's talk about cash. You know, your thoughts on the map in general, and then as we break down into these two teams playing it.
Like you said, it's an excellent map for competitive play. The middle is crucial for both teams to hold. Gaining middle as a terrorist means you have full access to both sites, and CTs have very limited information. So the CTs generally play really heavy on the middle, try to prevent the tees from an early take. Maybe later in the rounds, you'll see them spread off of middle and play two in B, three in A. Maybe one in spawn instead of three in A. The map is also really awesome for executes on A. So you may see like smokes over the A wall with terrace wrapping around the site. It's really cool to see stuff like that. Terrace taking up the, we call it highway, but it's from middle to the A site. Also, you could see Molotov strats in B using the window. So, I mean, the map is really open for anything. It's a fantastic map for competitive play, and I just really hope we can see some good strategy.
Yeah, I mean, Nip play this map a lot, and I cast a scan invitational that they played in, where they pick cash pretty much every round, but they were losing to teams on it. This is when I was like, was this really Nip's pick? They lost to a team called Online Bots, who are Estonian. No, seriously.
I do remember that. Yeah.
Estonian and Finnish mix, and I think they lost 16-4 on it, and I was like aghast. Yeah. And I was thinking, well, they got gamed on a map they didn't know. But then when I spoke to Nip after the game, they were like, no, we play the map all the time. We're really good at it. And I was thinking, you weren't today, brother.
No,
so, it's crazy.
It's epic. All of the pro level teams love cash because it's a sound map. There's no holes in it. It really is perfect as far as setups go, where you can play like 2-1-2. There's that solid middle, solid A, solid B.
Yep.
Vent rotating to B. It's excellent.
Classic layout, classic everything, you know?
Exactly.
And again, that being said, it's time. We're going to go ahead and show that winning moment from Nip, and then we're going to go right back to Anderson Semler for Game 2 Grand Finals.
Matthew Flaren has really been stepping up his game here in the second half. He does miss the shot, but Forrest will not. Now it's a 3-on-1, and ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be NIP taking the first map away from Fnatic here in the grand final at ESL 1 Cologne. What an upset. This is the map that Fnatic picked.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, and we get to see it all again. The win here on the first map for Nip. This is now, I mean, they are now the team to stop here. They are one map away from securing their first major title after two times in the finals. Fnatic, how are they going to stop them here, Anders?
I really don't know. I think our analyst panel covered it really well. This has to be devastating, losing that many rounds in a row. And Sean puts up a really good point. You know, Pronex is the guy responsible, and I guess in a way also Devilwalk, losing that many rounds on the second half of the map that you picked is going to be confidence shattering. But cash is a map that Fnatic definitely know. This isn't like one of the new maps like Overpass or Cobblestone that they may be a little bit shaky on. Mm-hmm. They know the map works. The question is if they know it better than NIP. I have a sneaky suspicion that Fnatic are going to come back swinging hard here. If they win the pistol round, I could see Fnatic going completely nuts.
No doubt about it. And I mean, Fnatic, if there is one thing, they're just going to come out, and you're right to say swinging, because I think they need to shatter Nip early on here. They really need to deal a huge blow to Nip's confidence right out the gates, right off the bat on this second map. Not let Nip just carry that momentum over from the first map. But I was talking to Get Right during the break. We were outside, and you know, obviously he's like, it's not over yet, man. It's not yet over. But we'll show you some tricks. So he's looking at me dead in the eyes, he's like, we'll show you some tricks on cash.
Well, look, that kind of mentality is actually really important, because we were talking about it during that second half on Cobblestone, when they were jumping down in the middle and they actually almost lost that round. So for Get Right to assume that kind of mentality and say, all right, it isn't over till it's over, because if they start pretending that they've already won, that's exactly when Fnatic get an opening into it. So they can't really afford that at all. They got to keep their heads in the game. And obviously, they've been playing for such a long time that there's no way they don't know this already.
Of course. I mean, we're talking about, well, seen as the most consistent, the best team in the world, Nip, versus a major championship title holding team right here. And Pronax, you know, everybody's talking about how his leadership has led one team to the title. Now he's here again in the finals. These guys know exactly what they have to do. These guys know that it's not over until you see that 16-0 on the scoreboard, until you see that you have got all the rounds and you can stand up and just go crazy. But the crowd here is so hype. The Get Pro 90 is right.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen in the audience, can we give a cheer for Fnatic? If you want to see that third map here in the grand finals, then clap for them. They do need some support right here.
Oh yeah.
Not a lot of Fnatic fans in the audience right here, it seems.
I'm having flashbacks of DreamHack Winter.
Yeah, that was actually
Vox Eminor led the cheer section for Fnatic, but it wasn't the big one. Everybody there was cheering for Nip, so let's go ahead and see who here wants to see Nip take this second map in the grand finals.
All right, a lot more of a presence here for the NIP team.
No, and Titan, you're still best.
Now, What's really interesting is we do have two Swedish teams. In the last one, we had a French and a Swedish team playing semi-finals, grand finals here at in Cologne in Germany. And people were stacked up all over the scene. People wanted to watch. There's so many people outside that they can't actually fit inside where we have the seating area. Mm-hmm. What happens if we could get a top German team? That's what I want. And I would love to see that one day.
That would be amazing. But this is also why this LAN right here, this major championship, is so important, because really you can make the claim to being the best team in the world if you take it. There is none of that that home crowd support, right? Because look at DreamHack Winter in Sweden at DreamHack, two Swedish teams in the finals. Everybody's going crazy, but the crowd is incredibly hyped for NIP. In Katowice, Poland, when VODS Pro took it, the entire crowd is constantly chanting VP, VP, VP. Here in Germany at Gamescom, there is no German team.
No, but
it is a Swede. It's two Swedish teams here battling it out.
Yeah, and the audience is still here for it. That's what's so cool about this whole situation. So that's what I'm saying is, if we could get a German team in here, that'd be even better for it right now. Do we have Tosspot down in front, having a snack with Edward?
Edward, I mean the man with the beard, the godlike beard.
And Pansy all the way to the right too.
Pansy's here, and Steel as well. And they went on a muffin run actually. During the break, so they're well equipped for this second half. They're going to keep their energy up to keep those cheers going. But everybody, what is it, Dorp? Drop? Oh, there it is, it's Drop. That's right, Drop's in the chat, but also Drop's in the on the stream here. If you're tuning in live in GoTV or on Twitch, make sure that you connect your Twitch account to your Steam account, because there are items that do drop while watching, and they have the cool stickers on it. All the Katowice, or not all the Katowice, obviously, but the Gamescom stickers plastered on those skins, and they are quite cool. Carlton has made it here as well.
All right, guys, in the audience, now is the time. This is the grand finals. The League of Legends stage is pretty far away, but let's see if we can make them hear us. Are you ready? On one, two, three, let's give a cheer here for Global Offensive. Let's go.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. I'm sure they heard it.
Now, we did challenge the League of Legends community, and I'm actually really pleased because they took it so well. It was actually on the top of the League of Legends subreddit, and a lot of people were saying, look, I've never watched any Counter-Strike, but I tuned in because of this thread, and now we're just having fun watching it. So maybe there is potential for some sort of synergy between the two communities. That'd be good fun. And we do have, obviously, a ton of new people who are joining our community, so a big welcome to all of you. If you've never been watching Counter-Strike before, then you've joined at the perfect time.
All right, well, be sure to spread the word, guys. We have to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we will be here for our second map of the grand finals between Ninjas in Pajamas and Fnatic here at Gamescom.